Good evening, you're watching the Indian Express and we are back with today's three things you need to know about the Bihar elections. The Bihar contest, which till a few months ago seemed pretty much advantage NDA, has now heated up quite a lot. It has become a lot more interesting and major reputations are at stake, including Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and also two kinds of identity plus politics are at stake. On one hand, you have the NDA, which goes for Hindutva plus development, and this time we have Mahagathbandhan led by Tejaswi challenging it with caste plus development. So in this election, we'll see which kind of identity politics and which kind of ideology the voters are preferring. So till November 10, when the election results are declared, every day we will bring you three key developments of the day you need to know about this extremely interesting election. The first thing today, of course, are the voting percentages in the 71 seats that have seen polling today. Till 5 PM, according to the Election Commission, the voting percentage has been 51.91%. These, of course, are not the final figures. And one thing we need to remember this time is because of the COVID-19 pandemic, the Election Commission had said that any voter who was found running a temperature at the polling booth or showed any other COVID-like symptoms would be asked to go back and return in the last hour of polling to cast their votes. So we do not know yet what the final figures are likely to look like, and this is too early to comment on what this voting figure means for the election. As the poll campaigning heats up, the barbs that political parties throw at each other are only going to get sharper, and these are very interesting because they show the political party's understanding of what they think will click with the voters. And people will only attack their opponents at what they think are their weakest points. So as campaigning progresses, this will be something to watch out for. So today we had Prime Minister Narendra Modi calling Tejaswi Yadav the Yuvraj of Jungle Raj.
Aap man mein sochiye, Jungle Raj ke Yuvraj, Jungle Raj ke Yuvraj, kya wo Bihar ko IT ke kshetr mein या आधुनिकता के किसी भी क्षेत्र में आगे ले जा सकते हैं।
This of course is a dig at the poor governance that Bihar witnessed under Tejaswi Yadav's father, Lalu Yadav. And Tejaswi has been fighting hard to shed that baggage, but it is sticking. And the fact that RJD is conscious of this Jungle Raj image is that Lalu Yadav and Rabri Devi actually do not figure prominently on a lot of the RJD posters, even though a lot of the votes that Tejaswi is banking on are thanks to his father's legacy. On the opposition's part, we had Tejaswi today call the Bihar government, comparing the Bihar government with General Dyer, the British officer responsible for the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. This was in reference to the Munger firing of October 26, late night on October 26. One man was killed and some people were injured when the police fired at a crowd of people who had gathered to immerse Durga Puja idols. There was some scuffle about the immersion of the idols and a firing ensued. So as we had expected, this is snowballing into a major political, major electoral issue, and Tejaswi has been attacked. The BJP government, Tejaswi as well as Congress, the Mahagathbandhan allies, are trying to push the NDA on a back foot at that. The third thing we have today are the seats that are in the fray and what battles are on at these seats. So in these 71 seats, the Mahagathbandhan and the BJP pretty much seem evenly placed. It is the JDU which is in trouble because at least on 10 seats, it is in a direct contest with an LGP candidate. And in many cases, the LGP candidates are actually BJP rebels. People who did not get a ticket from the BJP joined the LGP and are fighting on an LGP ticket right now. The LGP's strongholds include Dinara, Suryagrah and Amarpur. Now, how these seats go will tell us how well the JDU and the BJP workers have been able to coordinate on ground after LJP muddied waters with Chirag Paswan walking out of the NDA alliance. Also, today one very interesting thing that we will be able to draw some conclusion about is the crowd that we have been witnessing at Tejaswi's rallies, which is what political observers are actually thinking as the main surprise factor of this election. We will be able to see if that crowd was simply out of curiosity or if there's actual enthusiasm for Tejaswi and the RJD. Thank you for watching Indian Express. Tomorrow we'll be back with three things you need to know about the Bihar elections.